Well, we're well into sapping season. You've seen us hanging our buckets. Now it's time to boil sap. We've been boiling for a while now. And what I do, because I can't sit here all day long and boil, I boil when I can, and then I let it go to rest at night. And then the next day, I just start the fire up again and add some more sap to it. Very technical here. Use a bucket. And it was, I let it simmer off last night, and even just simmering, I lose a bucket and a half of liquids from the sap, water. Leave some sugar behind, that's the idea. See how our firebox is doing. Move the ashes out of the way so we get a good flow of air coming in. We use birch bark, and you don't need much of it. Better than newspaper. I use birch bark for a lot of things, so I generally have a lot of extra kicking around. I'm using some old shingles as kindling. It really doesn't take much to get this thing going. This is ash that I've split up real fine, a lot finer than you would for, say, a wood stove in your shop or something. And then once I shut this door, it starts drawing air from underneath, and it's like having a blowtorch in there. In just a matter of minutes, it'll get it'll catch and get going real good. And if I fill this fire, I let it get started first, like with that much, and then I can throw in a bunch more. And with one load of wood in this firebox, this pan will start jumping, the sap will start boiling real fast. The pan has what they call fins down. There's three fins. Those are the dark stripes, if you can see that in the through the sap. And those go down about 4 inches into the flue of the, you know, with all the heat goes. So you're getting heat on both sides of that bin. Heats it up like, wow, it's so good.
I can hear it roaring already.
Yeah. It's good and caught. Didn't take much to get her going. That's what's nice is during the day, while I'm trying to do other things, I like to get it hot, and just by getting it hot, hotter than the air temperature, it's gonna steam and evaporate. Maybe not as fast as if you're sitting in here just charging it up. So we get it jumping, you know, the stuff will be jumping up this high, the froth and foam and all, and pretty impressive. Sometimes a little scary if you've ever scorched a pan. It's scary. You scorch a pan, you've lost the whole bunch. So you want to pay attention, and yeah, you don't want to overboil it.
Yeah.
You can. I've learned not to fill this box up too full. Yeah.
You can overboil it is the issue.
Yeah, you can. You don't want to.
You don't want to.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the one thing that you try to avoid.